Hi everybody, this is Atiq. I welcome all of you to my YouTube channel Engineering Drive. Today I am going to discuss about one of the most important topic of our subject data structures, and it is a part of very very important concepts of graphs. So today I am going to speak about DFS, that is depth first search algorithm. Okay, already you know that in our previous video I have started the concepts of graphs to you. Okay, I discuss each and everything related to basics about graphs. Now I am going to start the important and very primary topic of our graphs, that is DFS, that is depth first search algorithm. Okay, you know there are very very less question papers of DS which does not contain this topic of DFS, and there is one more topic related to this one is BFS, breadth first search algorithm. So these are the two very very important algorithms of the subject data structures and in the topic of graphs. So today I am going to speak about DFS, depth first search algorithm. So what is mean by DFS? Let us have a clear understanding on the definition first. DFS algorithm traverses a graph in a depthward motion. So this is very very important point. Okay, what is the meaning of depthward motion? Which means from top to bottom. This algorithm works by traversing our vertices in a depthward motion and uses a stack. This is second important point. DFS makes use of stack to remember to get the next vertex to start a search when a dead end occurs in any iteration. So my dear students and my dear viewers, you should remember only one point here, that is depth first search algorithm, how it is going to traverse our graph in a depthward motion, that is from top to bottom. That is very very crucial point. And the second point that you need to remember along with this one is it will make use of stack to remember that when it is going to reach to the next vertex. Okay, so this is the primary point and this is the secondary point. Now let us see with one graph now how this depth first search algorithm works. You can see here I have taken one graph here, and it contains so many vertices from S, then A, B, C, D, E, F and G. Now how our depth first search algorithm traverses the graph? I already told you this is the first point. What is that? It will traverse a graph in depthward motion, which means you can see here from S to A, from A to D, D to G. Okay, once it will come at the bottom, again from bottom D, G to E, E to B. Okay, this is fifth step. Again sixth step starts from here, G to F and F to C. So which means we have visited all the vertices in our depth first search graph. Okay, now this is one clarity that we got now. And one more point we need to understand, my dear students, is this. There are three important rules that we need to remember in order to traverse our graph by using DFS. What are those three rules? Let us see. First of all, rule number one, visit the adjacent unvisited vertex, mark it as visited, display it, push it in a stack. My dear students, once I will tell the example, then you will clearly understand the concept. Okay. Meanwhile, if you are thinking that the topic is a little bit difficult, sir, for us, then actually you are doing a big mistake here. You just listen the example first, then you will understand it very clearly. So rule number one that we need to use to traverse the graph in a DFS fashion is we need to visit the adjacent unvisited vertex first, and we need to mark it as a visited. How we can mark it as a visited? Once we push that particular element or vertex in a stack, which means simple meaning of this rule one is, once we visit the adjacent unvisited vertex, what we need to do? We need to enter that vertex in a stack. That is rule number one. Rule number two, if no adjacent vertex is found, let us say there is no adjacent vertex found in the graph, then what you need to do? We need to pop up the vertex from the stack. This is very very important point. If the adjacent vertex is not found, which we have not visited, what we need to do? We need to pop up the vertex from the stack. How long we need to pop up all the vertices from the stack? until we do not have any adjacent vertices. If we don't have adjacent vertices, we need to remove the element from the stack. And the last rule, rule number 3, repeat rule 1 and rule 2 until the stack is empty. My dear students, you got finally one point, that how long we need to continue this DFS until the stack should become empty. Okay, so the primary two rules that you all people should remember is, if the adjacent unvisited vertex is found, enter that vertex in a stack. If no adjacent unvisited vertex is found, pop up the vertex from the stack. These are the two rules that you people should remember. Okay, now if you understood 50%, it is enough. Now the remaining 50% you will understood with the help of this example. Let us take, I have taken one example now, how the depth first search algorithm works, how we are going to traverse it with the help of DFS. Let us see. This is our graph that I have taken, which consists of 5 vertices, S, A, B, C and D. Okay, now stack is empty, because initially our stack will be empty. Now my dear students, which vertex we should visit first? Now which we should select one starting vertex. Now which vertex should I select? Always select the starting vertex as the first vertex. Now what I am going to do, I am going to take this vertex now, which is the S. So see here, you can see that S came in little bit in shaded color. So once I have visited S, then what I need to do, immediately I need to enter this S in the stack, push this S into the stack. Okay, that's what I have done. Now can you tell me what I should do next? Now the second step is adjacent vertices related to S. Which are the adjacent vertices of S? We can see for S we are having 3 vertices, A, B and C. So 3 adjacent vertices are there, sir, for S. Which one we should select, sir? That is your next question. My dear students, select the vertex which is in alphabetical order first, which means A, B, C are the 3 vertices of S which are adjacent, which in according to alphabetical order, which one will come first? Of course, A will come first. Yes or no? That's why what I am going to do, I am going to visit A first. Once I have visited A, what I need to do immediately, I need to enter this A in the stack. You can see. So I got S and I got A. Okay, S visited, A visited. Now my dear students, which one I need to visit now? Now I need to visit the next adjacent node related to A now. So for A, I can see that there are 2 adjacent nodes. One is S, another one is D. S already I have visited. Yes or no? So what I am going to do, which node I should, which vertex or which node I should select here? I should select now D. Okay, because D is unvisited vertex or D is unvisited node. So enter D into the stack. Okay, my dear students, don't get confused with the word node or vertex. We can use both, but generally I recommend to all of you to make use of the word vertex in when we are talking about graph. If you are using nodes also, it is not a problem. Okay, clear? Now D also entered into the stack. Now take the example. Now which is our visited node now? Which is visited vertex? D. So for T, which are the adjacent vertices? A, B and C. A is already visited one. B and C are not visited. Yes or no? It is clear. Next thing, whether I should select B or whether I should select C, sir? The answer is, select always the vertices, unvisited vertices in the alphabetical order. If I select in the alphabetical order, which node, which in a vertex I should insert into the stack? The answer is B. Now see here, B entered into the stack. Hopefully the doubt has been clear to you. Now B I have visited now. Now if I select the node or vertex B, now what are the adjacent nodes for B, adjacent vertices? One is S, another one is D. Both are visited one. So both adjacent vertices are visited one. So what I should do in this case, remove the top node from the stack. So which is the topmost node in the stack? B. So pop out B. Okay, once you pop out B, what happened now? You can see here, we check the stack top for returned in the previous node and check if it has any unvisited node. Here to find D to be on the top of the stack. Now we got D again on the top of the stack. So what we need to do, my dear students, once we got D, which are the adjacent vertices to D? A, B and C. And which is the unvisited adjacent vertex? C is the unvisited adjacent vertex. So insert C into the stack. Because once we found the unvisited adjacent vertex, once we have visited it, immediately we need to push into the stack. That is the rule. So C also pushed into the stack. Clear? Now we got one clear picture that all the vertices in the graph has been visited. And because how we can confirm it? Because all of the vertices we have inserted into our stack. All the nodes we have inserted into our stack. Clear? Now the next thing is, once we have visited, what we need to do now? We need to remove out one by one vertices from the stack. Why we need to remove out? Let us see this point. Only unvisited adjacent node is from D is C now. That's what we have entered here. So visit C, mark it as visited and put it onto the stack. Next thing, as C does not have any unvisited adjacent node, because C we don't have any unvisited adjacent node. So we keep popping the stack until we find a node that has an unvisited adjacent node. In this case, there's none, and we keep popping until the stack is empty. My dear students, what we will do? We will see C. Whether we got any adjacent unvisited node? No. Because S is visited one, D is also visited one. Remove C. Next to D. Take D. Any unvisited adjacent node is there for D? A, B and C. All are visited one. Pop up D. Next to A. A. Any, what are the adjacent adjacent nodes for A? S and D. Whether they are visited or unvisited? Visited one. Remove A. Next to, last one, S. So what are the adjacent nodes for S? A, B, C. All are visited one. Remove S. Finally, the stack will become empty. Once the stack will become empty, our DFS algorithm stops here. Our traversing of our graph by using DFS will stop here. My dear students, you need to remember only two rules here. Now I will explain the rules. Now our example has been completed. Now you can understand these rules. First, we need to visit the adjacent unvisited vertex. We need to mark it as a visited and we need to push into the stack. That is the first rule. Rule number two, if no adjacent vertex is found, pop out the vertex from the stack or pop out the node from the stack. These two rules we need to repeat until the stack will become empty. That's what we got in our answer also. Finally, we got our stack as empty. So based on our rule 1 and rule 2, only our algorithm works. My dear students, hopefully the concept of depth first search algorithm has been clear to you. So one last important point that I want to discuss in DFS is, you just remember these two points. DFS works in depthward motion, and second important point is, it will make use of stack to remember the information about vertices or nodes. So with this, let me close my today's session of video. In my next video of this graphs topic, I am going to discuss about the next algorithm, breadth first search. So see you soon, everybody. Take care. Allah Hafiz.